When I talk to you, I tell you what you have to teach the kids and how you do it. I wanted my kid to be a thinking kid, okay? I'm using old language. I wanted my kid to be creative. So I have to ask the question, what is creativity? If I don't know, I can't make my kid creative. So here's how I did it. In the beginning, he came to me when he was 4 years old. And he said, Daddy, the wheel came off my toy car. And I said, so it did. And I threw it in the garbage. And I read my book, but I'm watching him. And oh, look, wheel. And I said, what's the matter? He said, you threw it away. I said, I'll get you baby toys where the wheels don't come off. So he said, well, maybe I can fix it. So I reached for the toy and gave it to him. And he's sitting on the couch trying to get the wheel on. Then he gets it on. Just about a few minutes. Then I picked him up and put him in my lap. Said, that's wonderful. How did you do that? He said, I'm not that little. I said, but how did you do it? You see, the piece of iron's taken up, yeah. You see the hole in the wheel? He didn't even know what to call it. I pushed on the hole and pushed and pushed and pushed, and it went on. I said, that's marvelous. But if you say, here, let Daddy fix it for you, let Daddy do this, let Mommy do that, you produce a big blob that does no thinking at all. So put your kids, I used to come running in the house, so my little girl said, what did you bring me? She said, I didn't bring you anything, I'm too little. Kids are always thinking, so are you bringing him something? So when my little girl, when she was three, she came in the shop, and I put a wrench on a nut the wrong way. You know what that means? A wrench on a nut the wrong way? Nut, a wrench is a metal. And I put on, then I put on the wrong way again. She's watching me. It's so obvious. So she puts her little hands on it. That's no way to do it. So I says, is this all right? The wrong way again. Nothing wrong. I'll have to show you. So she put the wrench on the right way. I did that so she wouldn't look up to me. Daddy knows everything. Sometimes he doesn't know anything. So I used to come to my kids and ask them questions. I can't get this door on. What do you suggest? Well, I'm little, but I think if you put a piece of wood under the door to lift up to match the hinges, just put them in a situation. Kids of the future will be given responsibilities and they'll manage their own affairs. So one kid, when he goes into the woods, knows a lot about marine life in the stream. Another kid knows plants. Another kid knows clouds. And so each kid takes a turn of leadership. You have no permanent leader. If you rotate the leadership, it's better for the kids. Do you understand that? I don't want to be a leader. I want to give you tools to think with. Now you have to work on other people now. When they say, what if a guy doesn't want to go along with you? Just say, I don't know how to reach that guy. That's what it means. Say, you can call him names. Say he's dumb or this or that. Just say, I don't know how to reach him. So when I meet with people, if I can't reach them, I come at them another way. If that doesn't work, I try another way. Then I come back next week with a different way. When I use reason with my mother on a Japanese kid, it didn't work. Reason and logic does not change people. What changes people is your ability to reach them in their terms.